Hi, my name is Chris, and I'm a global support engineer for Dell EMC. And today I wanted to talk about configuring the power subsystem on Dell's PowerEdge platform. Now, the best place to do this is going to be in the iDRAC web interface. Once you've logged in, just click on Configuration and then Power Management, and you'll come to this screen. And our first option will be Power Control. This does exactly what it sounds like. You can power the server on and off. You can send a non-maskable interrupt if you're doing some diagnostic work. You can tell the operating system to perform a graceful shutdown before powering the server off. You can also choose to reset the system or do what's called a warm boot. This will reboot the server, but it won't power it off first. And then finally, you can power cycle the server or do what's called a cold boot. This will fully power the server off before bringing it back online. Next, we have the power cap policy. Now, this is a licensed feature for iDRAC Enterprise and data center licenses. So not every iDRAC is going to have this option, but it allows data center admins to set the maximum amount of power that the server can request from its data center. And the server will adjust its performance to stay underneath that power cap at all times. Under bursts of heavy load, the power cap can be temporarily exceeded by the server in order to accommodate that load, but it will try to adjust its performance and get back underneath that power cap as quickly as it can. And then finally, we have power configuration. Here we can set our power supply redundancy policy. Now my server has four power supplies in it, which means I get an extra option. Typically, you'll only see AB grid redundant and not redundant options for servers with two power supplies. But my server also has the PSU redundant option, which we'll explain here in a little bit. The default setting is going to be AB grid redundant, and this subdivides your power supplies into two different power grids. Since I have four power supplies, my power grid A is made up of power supply 1 and 3, and power grid B is made up of power supplies 2 and 4. In this scenario, if either power supply in power grid A fails, then we'll fail over to power grid B, and power supplies 2 and 4 will take over as the active power supplies. PSU redundant, like I said, is only an option on servers with four power supplies. And what this means is the power supplies are still redundant, but they're not broken down into grids. So if power supply 1 fails, the server doesn't lose access to power supply 3. It will still continue to contribute to the server's power draw. And then finally, we have not redundant, which again is exactly as it sounds. The power supplies no longer provide any redundancy, but they are able to provide their maximum wattage to the server. As an example, if I have an R740 with two 500 watt power supplies, in AB grid redundant, the maximum power draw that server could have is 500 watts. But if the power supplies are not redundant, then the server can draw up to a maximum of 1000 watts of power. I don't typically recommend using this setting for day-to-day activity, but I do use it for troubleshooting and diagnostic purposes. Oftentimes, we'll get clients that call us after having added a RAID controller or a couple of NICs to their server and found that it no longer powers on. If that's the case, I'll direct a support representative to come here into the iDRAC, change the redundancy policy to not redundant, and attempt to power on the server. If the server powers on, that's generally a good indicator that the customer has added more hardware than a single power supply can manage. And that's usually a good indicator that the client should talk to their sales rep about purchasing a higher capacity power supply, like a 700 watt or maybe 1000 watt power supply, in order to continue operating in a redundant state. I'll go ahead and put this back to AV grid redundant. And then the next option here is the hot spare feature. A hot spare power supply will be put into a low power or hibernating state by the server if it's enabled. If the hotspare feature is not enabled, then all of the power supplies in the server will attempt to contribute the same amount of power. Going back to my R740 example with the two 500 watt power supplies, if I have a hotspare enabled, then the hotspare power supply will be put in a low power state while power supply one, or the active power supply, supplies all of the power's needs to that server. So if the server only needs 100 watts of power, power supply one will supply all 100 watts, and power supply two will not supply any and will sit in a hibernating state. If the hotspot feature is disabled, then both power supply one and power supply two will each contribute 50 watts of power to the server. If we have the hotspot feature enabled, we will need to select a primary PSU. In my case, since I'm AV grid redundant and I've got four power supplies, I'm actually selecting a primary power grid. So in this instance, by default, it'll be power supplies one and three as the primary PSUs. These are the active power supplies, which means these are going to be the ones supplying all the power to the server, while power supplies two and four remain in a low power state until they're called upon. If the hotspot feature is disabled, then this option is grayed out and cannot be selected because all the power supplies are contributing an even amount of power to the server. And then finally, we have power factor correction. It's enabled from the factory, and its job is to increase the efficiency at which the power supplies apply power to the server and reduce what's called wasted power. For larger data centers, large amounts of wasted power can incur penalties and other fees from their power providers, and so having this enabled will help avoid that for them and just be more efficient and a little bit greener. You can disable this if you need to. The only thing that disabling power factor correction will do is that it will draw less power when the server is in an S5 state or a powered off state. So if you have to have large numbers of servers in a powered off state for an extended period of time, disabling power factor correction will save a little bit of energy in that state. Those are all the primary points of configuring the power supply that we have today. Thank you very much for listening, and have a good rest of your day.